Hi guys, my name is Tanvi and welcome to my channel Tanvi Diaries. Diwali is just around the corner and I assume Diwali cleaning is very bothering because we are already occupied with our daily routine, kids, office, and if you are a new mother, then it's a whole new world for you. All this cleaning can be very overwhelming and stressful on a woman because we want everything sparkling clean, right from our fans to our floors. And if you're a working mother, then you already have lots of tabs open and I know this is too much of extra work to ask for. Being a mother of a toddler myself, I thought of sharing my personal tips that really work well for deep cleaning my house. With the tips given in this video, you will not only get your Diwali cleaning done right on time, but will also keep you happy and easy to go with your daily routine by just spending 45 minutes to 1 hour a day. So, let's begin the video. My first tip is declutter. Declutter your mind. Without a strategy or a method, and cleaning whatever is coming your way can be very time consuming and exhausting. Prior planning is essential because we have thousands of things in our house that needs our attention. And at times we are confused where to start. So take a deep breath and get your list ready. Make a list of all the areas in your house that needs attention and be as elaborative as possible because now you need to focus on those areas which are not covered in your regular cleaning, like door gaps, sliding door panels, back of the paintings, balconies, etc. For example, if we talk about your bedroom, include curtains, study table, dressing area, closet, mattress, anything and everything under the roof that needs cleaning has to be mentioned. Assign a date to each task and promise yourself to work on it every single day, just for 1 hour. And you will see the magic. Taking down notes about everything might sound weird or time consuming, but trust me, it saves a lot of time because every day you know what you need to clean and you just have to work 1 hour each day. There are many things that can be multitasked, like microwave cleaning can be done side by side when you are cleaning your kitchen cabinet. Or you can put your curtains to wash when you are starting with your bedroom or living room. So write down all such things, all the electronic items or furniture that needs cleaning. Also make a list of all the cleaning supplies that you would need to go on with the cleaning process. My second tip is don't hesitate, take help. Take help from your family members, your house help, or wherever it's economical, you can take professional help as well. Cleaning the glass window might not seem too much of a task, but if it is done by somebody else, it will be of great help to you and will save you a lot of time. Make sure when you are making your list, assign some tasks to your family members as well because a family that cleans together stays together. Inform them well on time so that they can also plan their work accordingly. If possible, ask them what all they can help with so that it is not bothersome work for them as well. Time for tip number 3, book your services right now. If you want to get your sofa dry cleaned or carpets and curtains dry cleaned or any professional help, then please book it well in advance and well on time. Because last minute deals are not only expensive, but if your work is pending for long, that will give you a lot of anxiety. So book your service on time and finish your task. If there is a lot of limescale buildup in your bathroom, don't hesitate to take professional help. They do it really, really well and they have a nominal charge of 300 or 400 per bathroom. I prefer taking chimney cleaning, sofa dry cleaning and sometimes bathroom cleaning as well, depending upon how worse the condition is. My fourth tip is declutter. Declutter all the unnecessary and unwanted items from your house because they not only make it look cluttered, they also make it unclean and untidy. The moment you start cleaning these objects, you'll realize that you haven't used few of them over years or maybe you don't even knew that they exist in your house. For example, that old mascara, that old lipstick, or maybe expired medicines, or even that old top that is lying at the back of your closet because either you promised yourself to wear it someday or maybe you are emotionally attached to it. So time to get rid of all such things because we have a habit of buying new clothes and not discarding the old ones. If possible, donate them. Donate them to needy people or somebody who could reuse it. If you have high quality and very expensive clothes that you want to sell, then there are many websites on which you can sell your old clothes. And if the quality is very poor and something which cannot be reused, then please throw in trash so that you can get rid of it and save some time for next Diwali as well. My last tip is about the most important area of every house, that is kitchen. Kitchen cleaning can be very easy if planned properly and can be very daunting if taken as a whole. When some people say empty everything and then clean, or maybe clean your entire kitchen in one day, I prefer taking only 2 shelves in one day and keeping my countertop always mess-free and decluttered. Hold on to your new grocery stock till the time kitchen cleaning is finished because you might end up cluttering it again. Also, declutter what you don't want. Donate those old mugs, that plate that has missing pair, or that box whose lid is missing from past 2 years. Trust me, you are not going to find them this year as well. So please donate whatever you don't want and whatever you don't use. There are some areas in the kitchen that really go oily and grimy if not cleaned regularly, like the chimney. I know there are a lot of hacks available on YouTube and I myself use some of them, like baking soda, vinegar, cleaning with sieve and whatnot. But trust me, we all mothers have those days when we really don't have time to give that much of attention. So don't worry and don't hesitate to take professional help. I myself prefer taking professional help from urban company. They do their job really well and this is not a sponsored video. I genuinely like their services. If you're not happy with their services, then make sure to get it redone till the time you're satisfied. So that is the best part about this. So don't take tension, go easy, be happy because it's festival and we all want to be happy at the end of the day. Also, it's high time that you minimize the use of plastic items in your kitchen because neither they are good for your health nor for environment. Indians have a tradition of buying new utensils on Dhanteras and Diwali. So this time, promise yourself to buy something that is health and environment friendly. A new video on kitchen shopping tips will be up on my channel real soon. In that video, I will be sharing what all options do we have to buy on Dhanteras, what is good for your health and what not. So make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you get notification of all such informative videos. If you like my video, then please share it with your friends and family and do not forget to hit that like button. I shall see you soon in my next video. Till then, stay healthy, stay happy. Namaste.